Hey guys, this is David Kwan. So, last week, I finally finished Deus Ex. That felt like such a huge accomplishment to me personally, because it's a game where I kept trying to... So the first time I played it was back in like 2003 or 2004. I heard pretty great things about it. Deus Ex experience about... I love role-playing games, and I heard it's like... this first-person shooting game where it's not about shooting, but about stealth. I love stealth games, and leveling up, and building up your character, and using all these sorts of items, and coming into, progressing levels, because there's so many ways to defeat levels. There's many entryways, there's many exits. This concept sounded great. I started it, and... I don't know, I guess back in 2003, I did find it a really fascinating and a really amazing experience. Overall, even just from what I played my very first time, I think I got to like the sixth or so level. I got to the part where you have to shut down the Battery Park terrorist organization system. I got farther than that. I think I finally got to the part where, I meet Paul Denton, the brother of J.C. Denton, and I realized the truth about UNACO. I got to that far, and then somehow I ended up not completing it. There's life happened. I think that's what my memory says. Life happened, and then years down the road, I think 2008 or 2007-ish is when I revisited Deus Ex. I had a Game of the Year edition CD. And I put it in, my MacBook, and I think it was compatible with MacBook, but I still think I tried to use Bootcamp, which is running Windows on your MacBook. So I played some of that. I got really far that time. I actually got to Hong Kong, but it's still, after Hong Kong, I think I stopped playing it, and then finally, about a month ago, I started Deus Ex again on live. Online, it's problematic because it only lets you keep one save at a time permanently. I mean, you can make multiple saves, but then once you log out of online and come back to it, you only have one save that you can, the most recent save is the one you can load back to. And I guess this is something that online had to do for, I don't know, to maintain a server to be as smooth as possible. I don't know, but that really sucks because of the nature of Deus Ex. You can save anytime in Deus Ex, whatever. So, yeah, that sucked. But I got through it using that limitation. If I just played on the regular desktop with my Deus Ex CD-ROM, I would not have had that problem. It's only because online had that limitation. Anyway, I got through the game. I definitely feel proud. One thing I will say about Deus Ex, playing it in 2013, is this game has not aged well. It really has not aged well. And that's not just about graphics. Although graphics, oh man, that's not... But the mechanics and the way this game works, it really has not aged well. I mean, it took me a good time, like a number of hours, to finally get used to how this game works and functions. And then, in the later parts of the game, it gets really frustrating because these new types of enemies are introduced, and those enemies and the mechanics, just not compatible. It really has not aged well. Let's talk about graphics first. It's a very boxy game. I think it's like one of the earlier Unreal Engine models that this game is using. The environment are just... really just everything is just square and rectangles and containers. It's just really ugly looking and really dark. It's the environments are kind of colorless. The backgrounds, way out in the background, is like pre-rendered image. It's almost like if somebody took a snapshot of like hand-drawn art, like the New York City landscape at nighttime. The picture in the background, it's pretty jarring. It's really just like, wow. It makes you feel like this game is ancient. But the most disturbing thing about the game's graphics is the character animations and the character faces. I mean, when you go back to a game like Metal Gear Solid, the first one, you know, that game has not aged well because of the polygons of a character model kind of come out, and they have faces, but their eyes are just lines, right? Their faces are just lines. So Metal Gear Solid has not aged well, but it just doesn't, I don't know, Deus Ex's faces just really take me out of the experience. Characters look really weird, especially the ones that are like super futuristic, supposed to be futuristic and have augmentations. They have these veins running down, and they're all blue veins, and the way their mouths, the limb syncing is done, and it gets really worse when you mix it with the voice acting of this game, which can be quite awful. I read a lot of reviews saying that this game has like the most stereotypical Chinese accent of voice acting, and it's kind of true when you get to Hong Kong. I bared it, but it can be considered pretty unbearable. So, yeah, just weird. Mechanics is probably the thing that I have the most difficulty getting used to. Movement is loose. Controls are very loose. The gunplay, because it's supposed to be like a RPG mechanic, you know, you upgrade your abilities and therefore you upgrade your shooting mechanics and you upgrade your weapons to make it better. But it's super, just gunplay is it never feels right. Some weapons are just horrible, horrible ideas. The crossbow, for example. You can carry a tranquilizer weapon, and this is supposed to be a stealthy weapon, except it's horrible as stealth. I did find a great use for the tranquilizer crossbow, but not to be stealthy. This weapon, you shoot the tranquilizer dart at the enemy, and the enemy gets hit. And he's like, oh! And then, all of a sudden, every enemy knows where you are. Your location is alerted, and they will start chasing you, right? So, not a great weapon for stealth. But what ends up happening is that weapon keeps damaging the enemy that just has been struck with the tranquilizer dart. So the enemy's going, oh, oh, it keeps getting hurt. Until, like, give it 6 or 7 seconds, and the enemy will go, oh, and fall dead unconscious. So, in that sense, if there's, like, one or two enemies left, and then you have to get through this section, but you have to take these enemies out. I did find it useful to use the tranquilizer dart, trank one guard, and then just focus on the other guard and shoot him down, or trank one guard and just run away. But this weapon is just really weird that it works like that. It would have made much more sense if a trank dart worked like the M9 in Metal Gear Solid 2. You know, you pop it in the head, you pop someone in the head with the tranquilizer dart, and boom, he goes to sleep. And no one notices that what just happened if you do it stealthily. Stealth is extremely problematic in this game. I think that the stealthy aspect of this game, the stealth mechanics has not aged really well at all. The inventory system, a lot of the gameplay is just, it's a chore to play this game. It's really tedious. That's not what makes this game really awesome. If you're wanting to play a really fun gameplay experience, Deus Ex has not aged well. You really have to get used to it, especially the later parts of the game where it does become much more, you know, the enemies get pretty ridiculous, and you have to get really used to the game's mechanics in order to deal with them and pass through the level. So that's really the one thing, the first thing I want to say about this game. I will continue talking about Deus Ex in the next video. In the next video, I will start talking about what makes Deus Ex such a masterpiece, because it does deserve to be considered to be like such an amazing, amazing game. But it does have problems. It does, playing this game in 2013, if you've never played this game before, you're gonna have to take a couple of hours to bear with it and tolerate it, because yeah, it really has not aged well. So yeah, look forward to my next video on this. Cheers.